Hello guys, welcome back to another one of my videos. Let's see what's copyrighted on this video. Among Us, I did actually have that, and also Kingdom Dance, and also we have the same timestamps. So this YouTube short has 46 views now. I actually commented on it, and also I liked the video so I could get more promoted. So let's see how many views it has now after like 10 minutes. That's the last time I reloaded the page, so yeah. 56. So basically, people, even without any hashtags, people are still, like, feeling it. Okay.
New spot as an office, but for now this is gonna work for the next few builds. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. Drop a like if you did, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'm gonna see you guys later. Peace out. Easily. Use Grammarly and feel confident with effective communication. What's up guys and welcome back to House Flipper. Here we are out front of our absolutely ridiculous office. I love how this thing turned out, dude. Just built this in the last episode and I think it looks really, really good, to be honest. Like, I'm thinking this is like a fun atmosphere. It's going to inspire us to do our best work, and it's actually perfect because today we are going to be taking on a kindergarten project. Not a normal house situation here. We've got a kindergarten. So we've got an email from Ariel Loan. She says, "Greetings. After a few years of working as a teacher in a primary school, I collected enough money to buy a building which I want to change into a lovely kindergarten. It was used as an office before, so there's a lot to change. There's a huge mess in there now. I guess the previous owners didn't like to clean much. Please get rid of all the old broken items, fix damaged devices, equip the toilets appropriately. Rooms where children will spend their time should be as colorful as possible. They love it when everything around them shimmers with colors. Use at least 3 different colors in each room, and please put loads of toys everywhere, too. After all, playing is what children mostly do in a kindergarten. Also, don't forget about a locker room for the kids. Some hangers and shelves should be enough. I'm sure you can make a place which will bring big smiles on the kids' faces." So, let's go ahead and accept it, and let's see
what this is looking like. Turning an office building into a kindergarten. This should be cool. This is definitely going to be our biggest project yet. Look at this giant building, dude. This is the biggest thing we've ever seen. What's in the backyard? We got anything back there? No, not really yet. Love to be able to set up like a playground and stuff, but here we go. We're going to see what we've got going on. So lots of rooms. This is kind of like a storage room. The kitchen, absolutely disgusting. Looks like somebody was murdered in here. The bathrooms, we've got two toilets. That's kind of cool. Different types of toilets. That's weird. Another little office room in here. Gosh, this was a disgusting place, dude. And another office in here. All right. Well, it's a big building. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rooms. But I think it's a project we could take on. So, dude, I think we're just going to take this at a room-by-room basis. So we're just going to start in this first room here. We're going to clean everything up. I say we do all the cleaning and kind of, like, fixing first. And then we'll start worrying about the actual, like, you know, painting and decorating and stuff like that. So let's just do all the cleaning. By the way, shout out to somebody. You told me in the last episode if you go up and down with the squeegee on the windows, it works a little bit better. 100%, dude. That works way better. Alright, so we've got all this. They do want us to mount. I think I'm gonna mount here. Assemble the outlet. Alright. We can do that. Put these bad boys in. Looks good so far. Put that thing back. Face plate on. Boom, we're good to go. Alright, so. Technically, this place is done, but we're gonna be, you know, changing it up and what do you want to call it? Painting it, adding furniture and stuff. Dude, what happened in here? I seriously don't understand. How is this even, like, how do you?
There are 48 more space.
How do you even get this mess?
That Miss Linda knows what I've been through with the doctors. And she does research.
We had like a pizza party and just threw it everywhere.
Find
like
a doctor.
Understand.
You're not gonna get
him. Okay. Let's get the vacuum out first.
It's nice.
Gonna take care of this cockroach nest.
You always sweat.
So those guys aren't breathing anymore. And now let's just go ahead and clean everything up.
My shoulder to dry them when I
nothing like mopping your sink and your fridge, right? I don't understand. There's like blood splatters everywhere. And why do you have beanbags
so
in the kitchen?
So there's not a lot that we can do physically, but
sometimes
in arcade, we love it because we are big kids.
You gotta think though, this probably isn't the first time that this has ever happened. All right, so we got all that. We're gonna go ahead and hit this window real quick.
What was that? What? What did you say? Mama is a very affectionate, loving person. She's usually a
bubbly. You get fewer streaks when you go up and down for sure.
She tries to have fun.
We still have a little. No, I don't think we have any more. Well, yeah, we've got.
I might hit her. And it's very hard for me as a partner.
We've got 3% dirt that we need to fix.
Alright.
I almost guarantee you it's going to be a weird spot behind these countertops or something. Right. We're just going to call that one done for now. Into here. Lots of trash, no cockroaches this time at least, I guess. Oh, actually, I might know. Hold on.
Okay. Sorry.
Got it. Got the dirt.
If somebody touches
the windowsill dirt always throws me for a loop. I never think to, get it. We've got pizza residue in here.
It's very sensitive. I mean, I barely even touched you.
Got all that. Clean this window. Go up and down. You gotta go, like, slow as smooth and smooth as fast with this thing. Got that.
Yeah, we're literally having half a life.
Move all the trash.
We have to get back on track. We'll be back to having fun and just enjoy life.
I am scared of Dr. Lee because I don't have a lot of faith in doctors. In the past, other doctors haven't done their due diligence, and I hope that Dr. Lee can and does.
When I was young as a resident,
paleontologist, one of the things that you have to do is present to your superiors. And you really have to tell them the story of this patient, your physical exam, what you saw, and then you also have to include your diagnosis. And for thoroughness sake, in these instances, you really need to come up with all the
possibilities. Let's pick up all the main area stuff here.
From the most common to potentially rare conditions.
All the individual pieces are
really
frustrating.
You're really training to think in this way so that you can think of all the potential diagnoses here so that you can more quickly and more confident identify the things that might be more rare.
Still have a little of the dirt stuff. All right, cool.
Yes. What's going on?
Looks good to me. We're going to clean up the bathrooms. Oh, we've got some more cockroaches.
That's how I was.
Yes.
Why would the cockroaches be in the bathroom?
And
I guess it's like a
inward.
Damp, wet place.
Yes.
That makes sense.
And how long ago?
I was going to say, there's no food or anything, though.
Have you been seeing doctors?
I have seen over 200 doctors.
I kind of like this bathroom. Like, this is definitely a school bathroom. It's different than a lot of the other stuff we've seen.
It was adhesion,
which is kind of cool. I like doing different types of jobs, you know what I mean?
Okay.
It's getting more painful. It's getting bigger.
I go to another doctor,
and she's like, it's shingles, and sends me out the door. So I go to a different walk-in doctor.
We good?
And he tells me that it's a lipoma, and I was like,
got a little bit more dirt. I'm not sure where it is, but
wow, she's giving me a lot of different
solo
theories
window
here.
Tiny guy.
However, what I'd like
where's
to do now is take a good look at this, because sometimes the most simplest explanation here
it
is
says,
not what's going on.
Oh, no, we're 100% done. Okay, we're good.
All
right, on to the next one. Let's pick all this junk up. More pizza boxes, newspapers.
It is scary.
Nobody wanted to do any kind of testing or biopsy.
I can't
believe
nobody biopsied. Nobody
did anything. Now we're going
to
clean it.
So I'm just going to come take a look at it here. There's always two sides to a story. I can't judge a doctor just by what a patient may say. I mean, there may be reasons why.
Looking good. So far, let's clean the window. Your boy is like, the windows are growing on me. It's definitely a lot easier going up and down. I mean, you guys know I hated these things at first, but they're really not so bad anymore.
But if the skin is a little bit
firmer. Oh, we've got a leaky radiator over here. Radiator's cleaned up. Okay, we're at 77% on the dirt. Got some on the AC unit there. There's some over here. All right, 100% on the dirt. Nice, we're done with this room so far. And now we've got one room left to clean up, and we're going to be all done, boys. It's going to be it. It's going to be over. Don't need to do anything else. It's great.
Yeah, we sent it to a dermatologist.
How do these people just let the things come out? Or like, was it installed like this and they just never fixed it? I don't understand. Pop that up. Pop all this up. Wait, are we selling this stuff? If we're selling it, might as well just sell it.
Because I
can see he had favorites. Dude is hiding all kinds of stuff. A little bit of cleaning left, and then we're going to be done with this section, which is cool. Cleaning's not awful, but it's also not the most fun thing in the world, so I look forward to the actual creative process. All right, last bit of dirt there. Looks good to me. Okay, so we're going to go back through. I say we go back through the same way, and we just kind of, like, do each room as they want it, and we'll make this work. All right, so pavement colors are right pear and sunny yellow.
Family Guard brand.
Also, we want to place some objects. So I'm going to say, let's do the objects first. Sopa grenade.
Get
there. Small shoe cabinet. Wait, what colors we paint in the room? Pear and sunny yellow. I guess let's do the paint first, because the sunny yellow is going to end up being orange, and that wouldn't have looked good. So we'll do the paint first. That is really an ugly, unfortunate color, dude. But yeah, we'll do the paint, and then we'll get everything else according to colors. And like they said, I mean, this is perfect kind of timing, because we just did our office in really fun, crazy colors, and now we're going to have to do it in kindergarten the same way. So we're just going to, like, do our office again. Just kind of have fun with it. Yeah, this is an unfortunate orange. It's a nice green, though. I do like the green. I'm gonna go half and half. I think two walls orange, two walls green. We can just do the alternating stripes deal, but I don't know. So we need some more small shoe cabinets. What colors do we have?
Try down and free engine. We all
fiber for our digestive health. But
we could alternate orange and green.
Each day. Good thing Metamucil gummies are an easy way to get prebiotic plant-based fiber. The same
or
fiber as two
we could put the orange ones on the green wall
gummies, the easy way to get your
and the green ones on the orange wall.
$20 for the night, please.
$95 for the night, please.
Wait.
Now they want two times whiteboards. Got two whiteboards. 16 times hook.
Maybe you should try Tobago next time.
What?
Hotel? Tobago?
Listen up, you dogs with allergic itch. Today's talking lesson is just one word.
You seriously want to play 16 of these bad boys? Like that's a real request.
So
I'm assuming this is for like coats and stuff, and really I feel like this wouldn't work for hanging a bucket. I guess it depends on how big the hooks are. This would contain all in one small area, but I feel like they're all so close together that it'd be kinda hard to fit everything in here.
I've been telling everyone.
But
the secret to great teeth.
They're just gonna have to deal. I see what they're doing though, because we've got eight of these things, so two pairs of shoes, four, six, eight. We've got 16 pairs of shoes, 16 hooks, two whiteboards. Okay. Cool. So, first room's done. I like it. Moving on. Actually, should we get the hallway first? I guess we should get the hallway since this is kind of like the central area. Ceramic tiles, orange. Actually, you know what? I say we have some fun with it here. Let's do opposites on the ends. I like that. I like that. Now we're gonna go with this. Solid over here. This is not a good look in my opinion, but what do I know? I'm just the contractor. I don't make the rules. Alright. So, another room done. You got quite a few more to go, but we're gonna be okay. Okay. So this is gonna be the office. So we want the office bookshelf. And have a new one. But we probably want to change the color. I'm trying to match it to this stupid desk. I'm gonna go with the Maroque. I feel like the Maroque was the closest. It's not really that close. Mountable narrow curtain. Good. What colors are we painting the room? Paint the green and pistachio green? Probably stay with the white. I think if we go with anything but white, it's gonna get a little bit crazy. Hang those. We're good to go. Alright, we've got a mounted device. I'm assuming they want AC unit. Air conditioning.
To resolve it, but it's not something that I think is going to spread into and affect other organs in our body. I'm a little disappointed that you haven't had a biopsy before, because I feel like at least if you have a biopsy, we can try to pursue some treatment options, right? Which is now what we can do here.
Getting a diagnosis is a relief. It's a 5-year relief. Now I can breathe, I can not worry every day that something's going on internally. It was just exciting that Dr. Lee could look at me and say, I know what it is.
Yeah, I mean, there's things that you can do first. Start with the most basic things, which we can give you right now, which which are some really good topical steroid creams. You never had any creams that are really strong, prescription creams, and seeing if we can't slow that down. We just found out this diagnosis. Let's get you started on topicals, and then let's see how that does first. And it just depends on how you respond. Maybe you respond beautifully, you don't need anything else.
That would be
lovely.
You
know what I mean? I can't promise I can erase this, but I want to slow it down and have less of the symptoms and the pain, and you're beautiful.
You've done more than anyone else for 4 years.
Absolutely.
My hope right now is to try to move forward and get some things going with you. The first thing that you do with morphia is try a topical corticosteroid to help to blunt this reaction and halt the progress of this condition. Hopefully it'll soften the area. It'll help to prevent it from progressing and becoming wider. We really want to find the best thing with the lowest risk for her and the highest benefit. All right, so I'm going to give you an ointment. It's like one of the strongest out there. But you're applying it to that area twice a day.
Twice a day.
Okay?
I said, if we get nothing out of this trip across country but an answer, I'd be happy.
Yes.
Now that I have a game plan, it's given me a lot of hope. It's amazing that there's a medicine out there that can help at least slow the progression down. And for me, that is exciting.
Take care. Okay, take care, guys.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you, too.
This is the first doctor that listened to her, that diagnosed her, that tested her.
Dr. Lee gave me a lot of hope that my life's going to change for the better.
For better? You have an answer.
This is 5 years away.
I know. And she answered all your prayers and all your questions.
It's been 6 weeks since I saw Wanda, and she's been using her cream on her morphia diligently.
After 5 years of being misdiagnosed, it's been a process, and I'm glad that Dr. Lee was able to give me that diagnosis.
It's going to take some time to see improvement in this area, but I've really found her a great dermatologist that will help to monitor her condition and really help her to stay on top of it.
Dr. Lee is the only one that has worked really hard to lead me in the right direction with doctors.
Good luck to you, Wanda.
Well, I'm getting closer to taking this damn shirt off down here.
I know, I can tell the difference in you.
It's been 7 weeks since I met Dr. Lee, and my acne remains about the same. Upon my visit with Dr. Lee, she cleared out of several cysts that had walls in them, and since then, they have not returned, and my immediate hope is that they will not come back.
Well, hi, Jeb. How are you?
Hello, Dr. Lee. I had blood work done in order to start the isotretinoin, and it looks like there's some areas that are under review.
Isotretinoin is a medication that has to be broken down by your liver, so your liver has to be strong and be healthy.
Okay.
So your liver tests are a little bit elevated. I'm concerned about adding another medication that is going to tax your liver more. Both of our goals here is to try to get you on that medication and make sure that we can get that back down to normal. Let's get this moving forward, okay?
I'm still down to play the game, so at this time, I'm not going to be able to start that stronger medicine yet. But I am determined to work with my doctors in order to get that resolved and to be able to get started on that medicine.
I feel like one of those helmets is for me, so maybe I'll have to join you on the back of your motorcycle.
Don't poke the bear now.
Oh, don't go too fast, though.
Shout out to Dr. Lee for actually taking the time to take a look at it hands-on and give me some hope to look forward to.
It's been 5 weeks since the procedure, and I feel like a whole new person. My arm looks beautiful. It's still a little warm. The scar's flat. It's perfect. Before, I was scared it was going to hinder me from actually doing my job, and now I can fit in a skinnier spot with no hindrance. I'm back to myself. Actually getting together with the entire family.
Oh my goodness.
It's good, right? It's the type of thing we would do when my dad was around. I like to give a toast to my dad, to Pops.
Yeah.
Arms fixed, Pops. Love you. None of this would have happened without my dad. I'm super glad that I was able to keep the promise I gave him. Dr. Lee's changed my mojo, my excitement for life. My confidence is growing back, and I thank you, Dr. Lee, for everything you've done for me.
My name is Brittany, and I've been addicted to eating car seat foam for over 20 years. Eating car seat foam gives me the most euphoric feeling in the whole world. It's the high that keeps on hitting every time. So, like here, for instance, I would take it and kind of create a hole and then kind of do a slit. I try to make it not as noticeable. So I notice when doing up here, it's a little bit more noticeable. So I would do typically like a side, and then I can stretch a piece off. It is like fragrant, it's ripe, the aroma hits me. It's like my mouth salivates, is the very first thing that happens. And then I'm being taken into the experience. I just feel the firmness and rigidness kind of going against my gums and kind of going down my tongue as I bite into it. The thing that makes different foams different is the density of the foam. Me, I prefer like high density to medium density. It's pretty, it's nice, it's like firm. You just rip it apart. You can hear like the crisp sound of it. It sounds like heaven.
How does it taste?
Exquisite. You want some? I would say I eat car seat foam around the clock, like 3 to 5 times a day, whenever I'm watching TV, whenever I'm at work, whenever I'm dropping my daughter off. I will have some in my little carry bag so I can dig in and have quick access to it. Once I run out of there, I'll have some kind of tucked into my bra somewhere. Every pocket or pouch, anywhere it can hold, it'll be. It's always time to celebrate. It's always a time to be eating foam. That's my motto. My blue car, I had that car for 3 years. It took me 2 years to eat all the foam out of it completely. Not only do I eat foam from cars, I also eat foam from couches. I've eaten through most of it. I'm still working on this pillow right here. Car seat foam to me is the superior foam. Couch foam tends to be more softer. Sometimes you can taste like the chemicals in some of them. It's time to get a new couch because once this one is kind of like entirely gone, it's like going to be kind of unsuitable. towels, other little pillows that have other type of filling other than foam in them. And pretty much just doing this to try to make the couch just hold up and look as normal as possible. But at this point, I really have to get a new couch. I had to stop having company over because just the fact of having to kind of explain to them why the couch was nice and new when they seen it last and now it's completely all disformed. So I'd rather not have those conversations, so I pretty much just avoid having company at this point. You know how Willy Wonka has like never ending God stopper? That's how I feel with cotton. There's always some available. So rather it's gonna be the bed, the couch, a chair, I'm getting it everywhere. I started getting my sister's mattress around 8 years old, and I don't know what possessed me at 8 years old to just pick it up and put it in my mouth, but I just instantly fell in love with it. Growing up in the house that I did, a lot of people were very lonely, if that makes sense. Phone came at a point where I needed a friend and something safe that didn't have judgment, and that could help ground all of those emotions.
Caught?
Yeah, I've been caught a lot. My sister exposed my addiction to the rest of the family because she's a hater. Keep that part in.
I mean, if you have somebody that you care about that is doing something like that, you're gonna say something. Eventually, I think something's really gonna be wrong with her health-wise, and then she won't be around for my niece.
She's like my little broke best friend.
I love the taste of home, you know. It's the best home.
And I love the taste of home. It is the best home. Elijah's been aware that I've been eating foam ever since she was old enough to remember. She first seen me taking it out of the car when she was about 3 years old. She's like, why do you do that? Don't eat that. Eat this. And she would hand me like a french fry. And she's 9 now, so it's something she's accustomed to seeing, and she just, it's like, that's just my mom.
How long have you actually been eating foam?
I've been eating it since I was about your age, a little bit younger, like 8 years old.
Hmm?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Does anybody else know you eat it?
Quite a lot of people know. Most of the time I try to keep it kind of discreet and private. It's not like really private.
So that everybody will know?
Yeah, well, they will know now.
Well, Mom, I think it's complete normal that you eat home.
Why do you feel abnormal?
I don't feel like you're normal. I feel like you're better.
You're better than normal?
But you're better than other moms.
Oh, okay.
So with Elijah, I've always told Brittany since Elijah was born,
I don't feel like my eating foam has affected Elijah in any way because it doesn't change my state of being, so I'm fully me, fully present when I'm with her. I am in control of my addiction. I could stop if I wanted to, but I do think about the long-term effects that it'll have on my body, but I try to be present and focus on it now. And right now, it tastes good.
Skateboarder, a surf instructor in Hawaii, a firefighter engineer, and now I'm addicted to bodybuilding. From the time I was born, I came out and into this world setting records. I was the biggest baby in the hospital to the number one student in my high school. You name it, I do it to the max.
I think she's gone too hard her whole life with everything. I have no control over it, and
I don't think anyone does. I went to rehab, I did the program, I found something else to consume me, and it was health and fitness. I take my morning shot of HGH, which is human growth hormone. This is all prescribed to the doctor. It's to maintain lean body mass while burning body fat. People say, oh, she's my stairway freak. I don't care what people say. I like my voice. It's part of me. I think it's very sexy, and so do a lot of people that like me. Whether it's addiction or not, I cannot and will not stop bodybuilding. But now, I'm very proud to say, I am no longer addicted to bodybuilding. I forgot my protein. I am fit, fierce, and 60. Boom. Pure protein. My pantry used to look like a GNC or a vitamin shop before, and now I'm all about health and wellness. Big difference. Blueberries, bananas, and strawberries. The products I drink, the water I drink, the stretching, the exercise, all of it is in combination to look and feel fabulous, but from the inside out. That's the difference. Today, I don't need to push heavy weight. It's for maintenance only, and I'm good to go. I feel better now with more energy and more zest for life than even in my 20s. When I was bodybuilding, you know, it consumed my life, but today, a whole different story. I'm no longer addicted to bodybuilding, but I've taken on a new addiction. Thank you, Jesus, if you will. Some people say, well, yeah, you should transfer one addiction for another. Could that be a good thing or a bad thing?
I like this one. It looks good. It's bite, too.
You probably not got a little bite into this stuff, but you're certainly welcome to try it. I've got
well, I intend to. Uh-oh.
They tackle the worst house on the block.
I have to figure out how to fix this. It's going to have to be gutted.
And transform it into the best.
From AM to AM.
Bargain Block season premiere Wednesday, August 23rd at 9 on HGTV.
Did you know 80% of women are struggling with hair damage? Dryness and frizz that keeps coming back could be damaged hair that can't retain moisture. You need Pantene's Miracle Rescue Deep Conditioner. It's filled with provitamins to help hair lock in moisture, visibly repairing 6 months of damage in just one use, with no wait up. Guaranteed or your money back. For hair that looks healthy and stays healthy. If you know, you know it's Pantene.
I have a surprise for you.
I have a surprise for you.
What? Let's hit it at the same time.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
I booked a project at Captain's Log.
Free cancellation on most days. Booking.com, booking that.
Yeah.
Restore my natural barrier, so we're CeraVe Clean, CeraVe Hydrating Cleanser. Price pitch. Give it a day. Let's get
protection designed for worry-free sleep, try Poise overnight pads. With a 75% wider back, Poise's most absorbent pad provides up to 12 hours of protection to help you sleep worry-free. Try Poise overnight pads.
Call or text Berger and Green if you've been injured in an accident. Speaking with our team of experienced injury lawyers is always free. There are no upfront costs. You can't afford an injury lawyer. You can get a fair settlement for your injuries. Your questions will be answered. We're not alone. I'm Bill Kenny, and I only handle injury cases. There is no fee unless you get money.
Trust the name you know. Berger and Green, the injury lawyers. 1-800-999-2626.
Join us on Sunday, August 13th from noon to 5 at Carnegie Library, Pittsburgh. Summer Reading Extravaganza. A family-friendly outdoor festival for all ages. Grab your friends and head to the library in Oakland. Music, crafts, games, activities, storytelling, food trucks, and so much more. While you're there, don't forget to guess the total number of books Pittsburghers read this summer. There will be multiple opportunities to win prizes throughout the day, with the final number revealed and the grand prize awarded at the end of the event.
I left Cody because I can see my favorites.
You're now pushing me out.
That's an exaggeration. I'm a lie.
I think you're manipulating.
No.
You.
Sister Wives, August 20th at 10 on TLC. 5 98 couples will come together to face their relationship demons.
He's cheated the whole time.
Will they leave stronger than ever or say goodbye for good? 90 Day, Last Resort. Premiering Monday at 9 on TLC.
My name is Brittany, and I can't stop eating car seat phones. Today, I'm going to the upholstery store to get a brand new couch because I've eaten most of the one that I have now. If you know me personally, you better hide your couch. I ate all of the foam out of my sister's couch.
I think Brittany has ate maybe $12,000 worth of furniture for me. And that's just ridiculous, because I have to keep buying it over and over again.
I also went to my grandma's house and ate her couch, and then that's when it became a big issue within the family.
Yeah, Brittany's cost about $10,000 in damage and couches, because I think she ate two of my couches.
As I got older, I have my own money now to keep buying my own things, so I want to go ahead and get a new couch.
Howdy, how are you today?
Hi.
Hey, how's it?
I'm Brittany.
This is my nephew, Spence.
Hi, Spence.
Welcome to the upholstery shop.
Thank you.
So you've already found where we have the fabric.
Yes, we have a very great selection of fabric here.
All the fabrics are priced, including the fabric and labor, so you see one you like, that's the whole cost to do it.
And is that for the entire couch?
That's for the whole thing. That's the fabric and labor. Things like foam, or if we have to replace the legs, those would be extra.
Okay, well, what kind of foam do you guys have?
We have got every kind of foam you can imagine. I've got outdoor foam, indoor foam, soft, hard, everything in between. Tell me about your sofa.
So my old couch pretty much gave out, and so I'm kind of looking for something that's going to last a little bit longer.
All right. But you can feel how much firmer some are than others. This, for instance, is very soft, very firm, an extremely firm foam.
Yeah.
They're all hypoallergenic. The numbers that you see, the higher the number, the firmer the foam is going to be. That's the hardest foam we use. We use this for church pews. We had a guy that was 600 pounds, and this is what we put on there. He loved it. Most people, you just don't sink into it.
Yeah, I like this one. It looks good. It's bite, too.
Yeah, you're probably not going to want to bite into this stuff. You'd have to take it out of the cover and take all the padding off of it.
Yeah, I beg to differ. It looks like it tastes very good.
I've never tasted it myself, but when I shred it, I've gotten some up my nose. It doesn't taste that great. But you're certainly welcome to try it.
I intend to.
Oh.
I've had a lot of situations where some people have seen my addictions. I've been told that I'm weirdo, freak, so, yeah. And do you mind if I just take a look around?
No, of course not. This is our workshop. That's where all the work gets done.
Okay.
I gave her that piece of foam, and she was walking around with that foam cradled like a baby. And she walked back behind the fabric, and I couldn't see her. But when she came back, that foam was smaller. I think she was eating that foam back behind the fabric. I've never heard of anything like that. She kept asking me about how does it taste. Very strange. I don't think eating foam is good for you. And I cannot imagine what it would do to your insides.
And I can take this with me, right?
Absolutely. Anything you like. Just take it, try it out, see what you like the best.
Thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you for coming by.
When I get home, I cannot wait to indulge. Like, look at this. Like, are you serious? I don't care what people think about my addiction.
Not even your family?
No. My addiction doesn't really affect them. I know who I am, what I want, what I like, what I don't like, and I like me. And so anything that tries to get you to conform into something else or be something that you're not, I'm not with it.
Come on, baby. Get you home safely.
So much has changed since I've been on the show last. I was addicted to bodybuilding, and it really took over my life. You know, I didn't get married, I didn't have children, I didn't have time for friends. I missed a lot of parties, a lot of birthdays, weddings. I couldn't go because I was either competing or traveling. I sacrificed a lot for my career as a champion bodybuilder. There was no transformational moment, but I just realized how important friendships are. Just to see that, you know, I hurt people by not giving them my time. I just decided it's time to go another direction. I'm no longer addicted to bodybuilding, but I've taken on a new addiction. Jesus. Recently baptized, and it was such an epic experience. This is show me a sign, and there you go. The Lord powers 10 years ago would have been the gym 8 hours a day. The Lord today, I pray or in prayer with friends every day. I have Bible study the second Tuesday of every month, so at least 3 to 5 times a week, I'm at some church function.
I'm Dr. Kevin Chapman, and I'm a licensed clinical psychologist. I specialize in anxiety and related disorders, odd behaviors, and phobias. I think it's important to note that if you stop an addiction, it's still really important to recognize what the underlying cause and the factors that are inherent in that person that's causing them to engage in those activities to begin with. So in many ways, it's really essential that Lauren and others who have addictive behaviors and personalities, if you will, recognize the underlying beliefs they have about themselves and the brain chemistry that compels them to do the things that they do.
So yeah, this is my fun wall. I call it my cross wall. And all these things are just a reminder that who's important in your life. Again, give the glory to God and he'll shine on you. This newfound addiction brings me such joy. I mean, I get emotional about it because I'm so fulfilled with gratitude. What's next? God only knows.
My hair talks to me all the time. Well, maybe you can let me know who's going to win the lotto this weekend. You know, the Powerball is kind of big.
How about you just get the help that you need?
The only help that I need is removing myself from this conversation.
You can't make another human being do anything that they don't want to do.
We want for you to be fine.
Brand disinfectant spray. Use on 100 plus surfaces, including all kinds of school items. Yes, you are right.
S.C. Johnson.
Watch how easy it is to put on new hands-free Skechers slip-ins. I just step in and go. Doesn't matter. I don't even have to touch them. Ooh, gangsta. In a hurry, there's not a faster, easier way to put on your shoes. They know it, and when they see it.
Relapsing at my
MS isn't the only thing I have going on. That's why my doctor and I chose Kesimpta. Kesimpta's different. It's the only B-cell treatment for RMS I can take at home once a month. Kesimpta is proven superior at reducing the rate of relapses, active lesions, and slowing disability progression versus Aubagio. For me, a once-monthly treatment just works for my schedule.
Don't take Kesimpta if you have hepatitis B, and tell your doctor if you have had it, as it could come back. Kesimpta can cause serious side effects, including infections. While no cases of PML were reported in RMS clinical trials, it could happen. Tell your doctor if you have or plan to have vaccines, or if you are or plan to become pregnant. Kesimpta may cause a decrease in some types of antibodies. The most common side effects are upper respiratory tract infection, headache, and injection reactions.
When I'm ready, I spend less than 1 minute a month taking Kesimpta. How I spend the rest of my time is up to me.
Ask your doctor about treating RMS with Kesimpta.
Known as a loving parent. Known for lessons that matter. Known for being a free spirit. No one wants to be known for cancer. But a treatment treats. Keytruda is known to treat cancer. FDA approved for 16 types of cancer. One of those cancers is advanced non-squamous, non-small cell lung cancer, where Keytruda is approved to be used with certain chemotherapies as your first treatment if you do not have an abnormal EGFR or ALK gene.
Keytruda can cause your immune system to attack healthy parts of your body during and after treatment. This may be severe and lead to death. See your doctor right away if you have cough, shortness of breath, chest pain, diarrhea, severe stomach pain, severe nausea or vomiting, light sensitivity, eye problems, irregular heartbeat, extreme tiredness, constipation, dizziness or fainting, changes in appetite, thirst or urine, confusion, memory problems, muscle pain or weakness, fever, rash, itching or flushing.
She was overweight. She was always out of breath. That's when they decided to introduce the farmer's dog to her diet. It's just so fresh. She literally gets bubbles in her mouth. Now she's a lot more active. She's able to join us in our adventures. We're all able to do things as a family.
Get started at betterforthem.com.
For muscle cramps and spasms, TheraWorks absorbs quickly for relief. So get back at it.
TheraWorks.
For fast muscle relief, TheraWorks works. Try TheraWorks and get back at it.
When did I call Leaf Filter? When I saw my gutters overflowing onto my porch.
Leaf Filter is a permanent gutter solution, so you never have to worry about costly damage from clogged gutters again.
It's easy as going to make.
Call 833 Leaf Filter today or visit leaffilter.com.
Sometimes Jonah wrestles with falling asleep, so he takes ZQL, the world's number one sleep aid brand, for a better night's sleep. So now, he wakes up feeling like himself. The Brain Family Room Middleweight Champion. Better days start with ZQL Nights. The first time your sales reached 100K with GoDaddy was also the first time your profits left you speechless. At the counter or on the go, save 20% at the lowest transaction fees and keep more of what you make. Start saving today at GoDaddy.com.
Try Tide Power Pods with 85% more Tide in every pod.
Who needs that much more Tide?
He does.
Substantial factor in causing cancer. If you or someone you love use Roundup and are diagnosed with cancer, call the number on your screen now.
I'm going to I have not assembled an AC unit in this game yet, so this should be interesting,
wow.
Boys.
I get to watch all your favorite stuff. It's tonight. I'm streaming was never this easy, you know.
This is the way.
Okay. Match them up. Black to black, red to red, green to green, and white to white. We've got eight screws that have to go in.
You can try.
get way more into what you're into when you stream on the
There's the final one.
G
connect
network.
All the hoses. This is kind of interesting.
I'm Zachary Cohen in Washington. This is CNN.
Put that panel on. All right. Nice. I like it. And now we've
Here's
got
the question everyone's
green.
Was the dock brawl
We're going to have pistachio green.
This is a sad that there is
and,
no evidence of that. But tonight, there's a witness that's challenging.
I think for this one, I'm going to go three walls, one color, and one wall, the other color. So I think we're going to do the window wall, the pistachio.
You can hear men yelling, F that, N-word.
Give that pop a color.
As the black captain of the riverboat
and then everything
tried
else
to
is
going to
be this really
She also alleges that one of the
ugly.
Men arrested punched her son in the chest.
Why do you want a military green color in a kindergarten?
And then another man
doesn't really make a whole lot of sense to me, but
getting his gun.
Like I said, your boy's just the contractor.
Three
I'm just getting paid. I'm doing
charged.
What's
up. I want to bring in Montgomery Police Chief Daryl Albert. Chief Albert, thank you so much for joining us. People are fascinated by what's happening and the footage that has come out in this. Some have gone to the extreme of caricaturizing it and creating memes and the like. This is really no laughing matter for those who are on the ground and who are watching this. Any of this, what I just described from other witnesses about racial slurs having been used?
Well, thank you, Laura. And, you know, this was a devastating incident to our community, to the nation, you know. We've been conducting interviews and reviewing tons of footage submitted to us by the public. And we've watched frame by frame, you know, to make sure that we get it right. And today, we actually had that victim, that co-captain, back in our office conducting additional interviews with him. And, of course, we count on what he said. We believe what he's saying. And what he's saying is that he does not believe it was racially motivated whatsoever. But I can tell you this. The charges that we have now, being misdemeanor charges, doesn't mean they will stand. If more evidence comes forward, if there's more proof that this leads towards more of a hate crime, we will amend those charges and the charge appropriately. But right now, for what we have and for what we know, we are confident that we are heading in the right direction with this investigation. Well, this was horrible for the city of Montgomery, for the state of Alabama, and for our nation. We know, working with our local, state, and federal partners, we must get it right.
The fact that we're hearing this, I'm encouraged to know that there is always going to be a very important and prudent action, taking a second look to ensure that you have wholesome look at these cases. I wonder, this attack on the 16-year-old white teenager that you described, did that factor into the decision about whether this was racially motivated? Or as you said, you spoke with the captain a second time, and his conclusion was this was not about race or hate crime.
Well, you know, Laura, we look at the facts. We look at the facts and what they are. We look at the facts and we look at what the thresholds are to charge persons with a hate crime. And again, we lean on the Federal Bureau of Investigation for advice on this. We talk to our state partners and our local district attorneys. So we've exhausted not only the internal measures, but we look outside so that we can make sure we charge them appropriately. Like I said, as more evidence comes forward, as we interview more individuals, those charges can be amended, and there'll be more charges. You know, today, the two subjects that were still outstanding and had not turned themselves in as of yesterday when we spoke, they turned themselves in today, and we have those individuals in custody right now. There's more warrants being issued today. Again, we'll continue this, and whatever this investigation leads us to, we'll make the appropriate charges. We'll keep the news informed, because again, this was a horrible incident for our city. Montgomery is better than that. We are a great city.
Guys, that's KBV Interview and